QC.
Hey y'all, what's good? It's the girl Fats, and I hope you guys are doing well. I hope you guys are having a blessed day. I hope you guys are having a blessed week. I hope you guys are staying safe because you ain't safe out here in these streets. Guys, I'm back again with another video. Guys, so y'all know that every week I'll be reviewing Real Housewives of Atlanta, but this week ain't the week. There wasn't much that went on. There wasn't much that was going on. It was just them talking about what went down at the bachelorette party, and I just don't want to talk about that over and over again. And it was just like a lot, and I've already touched on it on my sneak peek review, so there's no point talking about it. If anything, let me just tell you something. Not much actually went down in this episode, but I really want to talk about Miss LaToya Forever real quick. You know, LaToya Forever recently shared with her followers and her subscribers that her grandparents are currently in hospital. They're critically sick. LaToya's grandparents have a nurse that looks after them, and also with the granddad as well. So they have a nurse that looks after them on a day-to-day basis. And basically this particular nurse caught the COVID, and she knew that she had the COVID, but yet she still continued working and taking care of the grandparents. And the grandparents ended up getting the COVID, and currently right now, her grandparents are currently in hospital. They're critically sick. Her granddad is on the ventilator and he can't breathe. You know, LaToya tried to speak to him, and normally they would have hours of the conversation, but he couldn't even have the conversation properly because he couldn't breathe properly. And honestly, can we please pray for her and her family and her grandparents? And you guys are wondering, why is it that I'm talking about this? Because I'm not gonna lie to you guys, I actually felt for LaToya. This time last year, my mum actually caught COVID. She actually got the Rona. My mum caught the Rona, and it was a very tough for my family. It was very tough for me. Obviously, I actually didn't find out from my mum that she was actually sick and she actually caught the Rona. I actually found out from another family member who called me to ask me how was my mum, if she was okay, because my mum wasn't picking up the phone. And I actually found out from another family member that my mum caught the Rona, and it was a very tough time for me because I couldn't go and visit my mum, and you know, I couldn't look after my mum, and you know, it really affected my mum because my mum's elderly and she's more vulnerable, and she's also a nurse. And you know, she was at home most of the time by herself because my stepdad was at work, and you know, she fainted a few times, and it was like a really tough time for me because I couldn't really go and visit my mom. I was in tears, I was upset. It was a tough time. Like, it was really hard. And for me, when LaToya shared this, I felt for her. For those who have watched her old vlogs, for those who have watched her old vlogs from her family channel or from watching her recent videos, you guys know that she's got a tight bond with her grandparents. You guys know that she's got a tight bond with her grandparents. She loves her grandparents. Point, she did live with her grandparents years and years ago, and her grandparents looked after her, you know? I wanted to do this video because I wanted to raise awareness. Like, guys, like, listen, this Rona is still out here, okay? This Rona is still out here, it's still in the air. Obviously, it's really affecting LaToya. You know, she passed out in the middle of a hookah lounge. She was throwing up because it's making her sick. The fact that her grandparents are in hospital, you know, she's getting all this anxiety, she's being sick. This is really serious right now. This is a serious issue, you know, and like I said, like, her grandparents are elderly, you know. Nobody could go and visit them. Nobody can look after them. They're actually in the hospital, like, and it must be a tough time. At times like this, it does remind us how much our loved ones mean to us, how much our parents means to us, and how much, you know, and, you know, we should, and the fact that we should be spending more time with our loved ones, because, bruh, it was a scary time for me. Like, I was in bits. Like, I was in bits. So whatever LaToya's going through, I'm sure she's going through a lot more. But it was tough. It was really tough. And it was really nice to see that her best friend or boyfriend, Von, was by her side. Like, it's nice to see that she's not by herself. And she's got Von by her side. You know, he's been her rock. Even though they haven't known each other for that long, but you can tell that this is a genuine friendship relationship. Like, at first, I wasn't sure about him, but as times go on and as I'm seeing them together more often in her stories, in her videos, I can see that he's very genuine. Like, he does really care for her. And, you know, I love their relationship. It's like, I love their relationship, like the way they vibe off each other. You know, she brings the hypeness out of him. And like, it's just nice to see, you know, after their little night out, Von posted like an appreciation on how much he cares for her and how much he loves her. Peace Report Daily posted this on their page, and you know, I was looking under the comments, a lot of people had a lot to say about it. People said, oh, she's so thirsty for a storyline. No, this ain't no storyline, boo. This is real life, boo. Like, her grandparents are literally sick. This is the person that's been in her corner this whole time. Like, it is what it is. We're here for it. I like it. Is it too soon? She wants to move on. She's living her best life. This man is showing her all this affection that she's always wanted. He's shown her all the love. And for some people, it might be too soon because it hasn't been that long since they've met. But for some people, you know, you connect with people a little bit faster than the other. And at the end of the day, oh, and another thing as well, one of the things I didn't like under the comments on Peace Report Daily, people kept bringing Adam into it and saying, oh, this is the affection that Adam couldn't give her. First of all, leave Adam out of this. Adam's out here trying to live his best life. In fact, Adam was actually seeing someone or talking to someone not long ago. Adam was out here in some resort with another woman, allegedly, who goes by the name of Queen Wa, I think. And you know, a lot of people out here in these streets were doing a whole lot of digging and seeing, you know, the resort that he was in and the resort that the other woman was in, and it matched the same, you know, the same environment, the flowers and the roses that this Queen Wa was holding. When I first saw the woman, I was like, hold on, is this Adam's type? I didn't expect this. But then again, it is what it is. Like, if this is what he likes, then that's what he likes. But I was kind of shocked because, you know, it was a whole lot. It was a whole lot. It was a Like, definitely not what we're used to, because LaToya don't look like that. These people are grown people. They can do whatever they want. They're single, okay? Or because the divorce is not finalized, that doesn't mean they're not getting a divorce. It is what it is. They're living their best life. Let them live their best life, guys, okay? Let them live their best life. But anyways, y'all, please go to LaToya's channel, LaToya's page, LaToya and Vaughn's page, and just show some love and support to LaToya. Let's pray for her and her grandparents, and let's pray for her grandparents' recovery. And yeah, guys, I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Please make sure you like, share, and subscribe, and I shall see you on my next video.